Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Certainly a 10 could be awarded, a 10 out of 10 to Mother Nature for today. Now, we're going to see a little more cloud cover move in during the weekend, but it's still going to be dry, it looks like, before the next round of showers gets here. A 3C night on the way for tonight, clear, cool, and comfortable. Low temperatures 46 to around 50 degrees. And for Saturday morning, mostly sunny and mild, warming up quickly through the 50s as the sun gets higher in the sky. We'll max out at 78 to around 82, so pretty warm and, again, pretty pleasant with mostly sunny skies. Just a little bit of thicker high-level cloudiness than we had today. Overall, still going to qualify as mostly sunny. Today was just really, really tough to beat. Northeasterly winds will be pretty light, 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunset tomorrow evening will be at 8:20. Some comfortable numbers already starting to show up. Selins Grove down to 54, 55 in Lebanon, Coatesville, Chester County coming in 57, York still at 60 degrees. And got to start talking about dew points now in late spring, getting closer to summer. It's a temperature that basically reflects how much moisture is in the air. And sometimes these are the only numbers that change day to day in the warmer seasons. Well, right now in the 40s and the 50s, that's way on the dry side on the comfort factor. It feels nice and comfortable out there. When these numbers are in the 60s and the 70s, that's when it starts to feel kind of tropical and it starts to feel kind of a muggy, but certainly not the case right now. Friday, high temperature was 75 degrees. The average for this time of the year is 73, so that was pretty close. The morning low was 48, a little below the average for this time of the year. And of course, there was no rainfall today. There was barely a cloud in the sky. But what's developing now, not very uncommon for this time of the year, along an old stalled frontal boundary, the same one that went through here the other day that brought us the soaking rainfall. It's developing a couple areas of low pressure as the pattern gets blocked a little bit, courtesy of some high pressure over the northern Atlantic. High pressure is over us at the current time, and that's keeping us dry. The clouds are already starting to try to make their way to the north. High pressure is kind of killing them as they go. But as the high begins to kind of move back off to the coast of New England over the course of the next 2.5 to 3 days, eventually the low will continue to move closer to us. We'll have an easterly flow set up that will eventually bring in some cooler weather. It'll start to bring in some moisture, too. But we're going to salvage the weekend, it looks like, and most of the showers should hold off until as early as late Sunday night, early Monday morning. The computer model may be a little slow on that. And a cold front will also be heading our way. First, we get some showers from the low moving up the coast, and then this front will start to move through by Tuesday into Wednesday, bringing us another chance for some showers. In terms of the effect on temperatures, no effect all that quick. We start out the day near 50 degrees tomorrow, then sunshine, and the strong sunshine gets us back up into the upper 70s near 80 degrees. Not quite as cool tomorrow night, so back up to near 80 degrees Sunday afternoon. But then when the easterly flow and the cloud cover really starts to take over, we're going to have trouble getting into the low 70s on Monday afternoon. So the 7-day forecast looks like this. Basically, Saturday, Sunday, almost the same thing. Near 80 degrees, just increasing cloud cover on Sunday. Then the showers start to arrive on Monday. We'll keep you updated on when we can finesse the forecast a little bit. We get most of the showers on Tuesday, then they'll be coming to an end on Wednesday. So, you know, just not quite as sunny as it was today for tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Still a nice weekend.
We'll enjoy it.
Speaking of things that happen in the sky, we got a lot of calls and emails tonight about people in basically southern York, Adams County, looking up in the sky, seeing military fighter planes, a fighter plane mm-hmm. surrounding a little small plane.
No doubt it has something to do with what's going on.
The G8 summit at Camp David in Maryland, which is just over the line from Pennsylvania. And we just wanted to tell y'all that we checked it out, and we were told it was just a regular military training exercise.
Well, we've heard that before.
I think maybe the pilot went into what is now restricted airspace and didn't know it. Happy little Friday night flight turned a little.
It'll be memorable, that's for sure.